For the past few years, I've wanted to move on. To grasp onto something beyond my reach. What that is, I don't even know.
Why is 5 centimeters per second rarely talked about in the anime scene? This may be because of it being nearly 17 years old now, or that it has one of the most frustrating endings in all of anime. To me, 5 centimeters per second has a special place in my heart. And I think by the end of this video, it'll be the same for you. To its magnificent art style, tear-dropping moments, and lasting life lessons, let me show you what makes 5 centimeters per second the best anime movie that has been forgotten through time. Chapter 1, Tale of Cherry Blossoms. Takaki and Akari are two students who have similar interests. They like to read, watch the cherry blossoms, and most of all, like to be around each other. They spend every second with each other, so much so that the other students made fun of them. Even with this, they laughed it off. Takaki and Akari felt perfect for each other. They felt happy.
This is Akari Shinohara. May I speak to Takaki, please?
Akari received news that she would be moving with her parents. And this devastated both of them, especially Takaki. They ended up sending letters to each other for a few months to keep in touch, until Takaki realized that he would be moving even farther. In a last attempt to rekindle the relationship, he went off to meet Akari alone one more time. Takaki planned out the train trip that he would need to take. It would be around 2 hours. On that day, it snowed. Hard. The trains delayed one after another. Who knew if Akari would still be waiting? The delays, his love letter being flown out, it almost seemed like the world was against the meeting. But against all odds, he arrived and saw Akari sitting in the waiting room alone. They talked, ate together, and ended up even kissing. But alas, they were to separate eventually, and as the night passed and the sun rose, Takaki got on the train again. During their departure, Akari wished him well, while Takaki told her that he would continue calling and sending letters. Takaki, unable to confront the isolation, hopes for the possibility for a future relationship, while Akari simply waves goodbye. This difference in mindset would set off a chain reaction to differing lives. Chapter 2, Cosmonaut. This chapter opens up in the perspective of Kanae, a student who is in love with Takaki, but has yet to tell him. Kanae tries to walk home with Takaki as often as possible so she can spend time with him. Often, Takaki looks at his phone, like he's texting someone more important than her. We later find that Takaki is actually texting Akari, but never sends the messages. One day, when everything is going right for Kanae, she decides to make her move. She waits for the right moment to confess her love. As they're walking back home, rocket flies into space behind them, symbolizing both the rocket leaving the past, but also heading towards a greater future. She realizes that Takaki doesn't look at her, that he doesn't look at her the same way he does to his phone, to Akari. She goes home and cries, understanding the reality of the situation and willing to confront it head on. Chapter 3, 5 centimeters per second. This last chapter shows a much older Takaki, a Takaki physically older, but still living in the past. We find that he has a relationship that has lasted for 3 years. Even so, he is unable to open up to her and ends up losing the relationship. Holding on to his love for Hikari, he is unable to create new relationships and in the end, hurts the people who love him the most. He distances himself from others, which makes him isolated. Living in the past, he is unable to focus on the future, nor the present. In the final scene, we see Takaki walking past Hikari. But as he turns around, a train runs by. We see in the manga that he actually saw a ring on her finger, signifying that she has moved on, and so should Takaki. Knowing that his promise all those years ago to meet under the cherry blossom again has died, he smiles. I watched this movie 10 years ago and it still haunts me till this day. It's a tale about what not to do and what happens when a person is unable to let go and move on. Relationships and any sort of connections are always in the moment. It's never will it end, but when it will end. We should embrace the connections we have now, as we never know when life may snatch them away. But if connections are impossible, we must move on.